Hello students, today we will learn about why priming is done in centrifugal pumps. Okay, so we will learn about priming. So we will learn the physical significance that why priming is done with centrifugal pump. What is the concept of priming? For that purpose we will learn. Okay, so over here what you see that there is a motor which is having a shaft. Okay, and this is a cord, and at the end of the cord there is an empty bucket. Okay, and the shaft of motor is rotating, so the empty bucket is also rotating. Okay, so however we are considering that this bucket is empty, but it contains air inside it, because this experiment is happening in atmosphere, so it contains air inside it. Okay, so in this case when it is rotating, it will develop a centrifugal force on this bucket. Okay, due to that thing tension is created on this cord. Let us suppose it is TA. This bucket is containing air inside it. Okay, it is running with particular speed. In case the same bucket is filled with water and then rotated, then the centrifugal force developed could be 1000 times to that of in case it is having air inside it. Can you tell why? Because the liquid water's density is almost 1000 times to that of air. So more mass is there inside this bucket. Suppose over here there is 10 grams of air. Over here in same volume it will attain 10 kgs of liquid water. So the tension in this cord will be almost 1000 times to that of in case the bucket contains air. I am talking about the centrifugal force. Okay, now coming to the topic, that this is the indicative diagram of a centrifugal pump. Okay, it consists of a casing. Okay, and this is the impeller inside it. Okay, this is the suction pipe and this is the delivery pipe. Okay, it contains a priming port also with it. I will tell that why this priming port is there. Now what happens in normal operation, when the impeller rotates, then water also rotates with the impeller. Okay, so it develops a centrifugal force on the water content, which pushes the water in radial direction against the axis of rotation. Due to that push, what happens, it ultimately emanates out from the delivery pipe due to that push, and that push is developed due to centrifugal force. Okay, so when liquid water is pushed and it emanates out from this delivery pipe, it creates a vacancy of water inside, vacuum inside, and that vacuum pulls fresh water inside. Okay, so what happens, the steady flow of water takes place by that push and pull. Okay, and the pull developed due to that push is directly analogous to the push applied to the water due to centrifugal force. Once again, water is imparted with centrifugal force. Due to that, it is pushed in radial direction. Okay, so due to that thing, that push, it comes out from the delivery pipe, and when water comes out from the delivery pipe, it develops a vacuum at the center, so water is pulled inside, and that pulling force is directly analogous to the push force applied to the water. But suppose that there is a centrifugal pump and this is a suction pipe, and it is not started, and the suction pipe is dipped inside water, and then the impeller is rotated by providing power to it. In this case what is happening, there is air inside. Initially what is there? There is air inside. So when air will rotate, in case just the suction pipe is dipped inside water and the casing contains air, and in that case the impeller rotates, then the air rotates with the impeller and the centrifugal force is developed in the air. Okay, so air is also pushed to go toward the periphery, but the push given to the air due to centrifugal force is almost 1000 times less than that of in case it contains water. Okay, so the push is less, so what happens, the pull which makes the water to go inside the casing is also less, because I already told that the pull which is pulling the water inside the casing is directly analogous to the push force applied to the fluid which is rotating inside with the impeller. So it will not pull any water inside due to this thing, because initially it contains air. Now to solve this problem, we have to open this priming port and fill this entire casing with water. Now in case we will start the pump, means the impeller starts rotating, in that case that condition is fulfilled, that greater amount of push is developed with the water, so greater amount of pull is developed so that water can go inside. This is what priming is. It is only done because just dipping the suction pipe inside the liquid water and running the impeller of this centrifugal pump, then the amount of force developed is only on the air, because air rotates, so centrifugal force is developed on the air. Centrifugal force developed on the air is 1000 times less than that of centrifugal force developed in the water. So sufficient amount of force is not developed to pull the water to go inside the casing. So this is the purpose of priming in centrifugal pump just to initiate the steady flow of liquid water to go inside and come out through the delivery pipe. It sucks the water from the suction pipe and it comes out from the delivery pipe. So hope you would have understood the concept of priming. Thank you.